state, our region, and our country. And I'm going to ask Mike Minogue to come up and speak about a program that he is very familiar with and is a leader of from the standpoint of jobs for veterans. And since we're out of time, Mike, I'm not going to give this long introduction, but you don't need it anyway.
So 19 years ago, I was getting out of the military. I am an ex-Army Ranger platoon leader. I'm a West Point grad, and I was coming back from Desert Storm, thinking about what do I want to do the rest of my life. I want to serve, but I want to serve and do something special. So how do you get a job? How do you have access? I just wanted an opportunity to go do something. And I wrote a letter to a crazy CEO named Jack Welch. And I attached my resume and said, you're the company I want to go work for. And through that letter, I got an opportunity to go to General Electric and go into the healthcare program and go into a field that really serves patients, not just the United States, but all over the world. Something that you can be passionate about, something that you can help people every day in every hospital. And I ended up here at AbioMed. We're a company that makes the world's smallest heart pump. We're around 500 employees. We manufacture here in Danvers, Massachusetts, and it sounds hokey and naive, but our products do recover hearts and save lives, and we've added more than 100 jobs here in Danvers over the last 18 months, and they're manufacturing jobs, engineering jobs. So I've been blessed, and I know I've been very fortunate because I had the opportunity. And Jack Welch was able to just give me the opportunity to get into a great program. And as I started looking at what was going on with our veterans, you know, we have been in conflicts for more than the last 10 years. Depending on which survey, there's hundreds of thousands of people trying to get out of the military after answering the call of duty to get a job. And they can't find jobs. Some of them, their whole experience has been being in the military. Some of them have lost limbs, and they've been in a hospital for more than 12 months. And when they go interview, they're told, you don't have any experience. You're competing with someone who has a PhD or master's, and you just don't have a lot of experience. And it's very frustrating for them. So we, the CEOs of the industry of MedTech, to these wounded warriors, wrote a program that wants to do a couple things. And we've been fortunate because, for whatever reason, medical devices has attracted thousands of veterans, CEOs from J&J to Hemonetics in Massachusetts to AbioMed, and we want to help bring these folks into our industry, make us a home. So it's the Medical Veterans Program. The website is medtechvets.org, and the goals are three. Internships, they're going back for their jobs. Mentors, to help them get jobs, and then full-time employment. And the way we do it is two methods. Number one is boot camps. Help them write resumes, help them interview, help them translate their skills from being in the military to the civilian world. And the other is a web portal. That's the medtechvets.org. Go find companies, go find the network. And Massachusetts should be very proud because MedTech is so prevalent here. The governor and the state did the very first state-run boot camp. And we have hundreds of people on the website, on the portal, but there's more to do. So what we're trying to do is bring it more local, bring it into the North Shore, and again, be very proud of what we do, give them an opportunity to serve honorably. They have worked hard, they want this opportunity, and again, we believe that the medical device field is a home for them. So thanks for the time to talk about the program, and again, it's an honor to have you here, Governor. Thank you.